morning and welcome back to the channel. This is Never Too Old to Rock. I'm your host Jim. You can call me Jim. If you're new to the channel, welcome. If you're already a subscriber, then you're fucking awesome. Don't let anyone ever tell you that you're not. If you just clicked onto the channel just to see what it's about and you haven't read the description, shame on you. It's a reaction stroke review of rock and roll, rock, metal, anything in between, and 80s music. I throw in the 80s stuff because not all of the 80s was bad. There was some really good shit in the 80s. Sorry but to let you know this, but there was. And it's still cool today. And I enjoy listening to it, and a lot of other people like listening to it, so it, for me, it brings back some good memories, so that's why I throw them in anyway, so just clearing that up. Anyway, how is everyone doing out there today? Hope everyone is tickety-boo. Did I really just say that? Tickety-boo. Fucking hell. Starting to show my age. Not happy about it. I don't care anymore. I'm at that age now where I couldn't give a fuck. So, there you go. Yes. We're all in lockdown here in England. Again. Everyone's losing their fucking minds. Me, personally, I couldn't give a shit. Could do with a few days off. But that's not going to happen. So I've just got to sort of grin and bear it. Today's video. It's from MMB TV. And he wants an old favourite of mine, Guns N' Roses, Civil War. Well, MMB TV said I will do it, and I always try and keep my word. If I can't do your request, then I would either let you know or talk about it in a video. And let you know that I can't find the video that you're after or whatever. But we're going to do this. Now this song, Civil War. When I first heard this, I thought, wow. You know, there's certain lines in this song that really sort of struck a chord with me, and I'll talk about that after. But for right now, we're going to do Guns N' Roses Civil War live in Paris 1992. And I think when they did this concert, Axl was having problems with a Hollywood actor called Warren Beatty. I think for coming on to his girlfriend or something like that. And he sort of mentions it in the concert before he does the song Double Talking Jive. But yeah, I think when I saw this concert, all the way back in 92, they actually put it on the TV. Which was rare in 92. 92, they hardly ever did that. But they did show this on TV, and it was in the afternoon. I think it was on a Saturday actually. And the TV people in the TV station probably didn't realise what Guns N' Roses were like. And when the FM blinding started, yeah. You get the complaints from the viewers saying, how could you put that on? I fucking loved it. I did. So, let's do this. Here we go.
What we've got here is failure to communicate.
Thank you. musical about what I do.
That really get me in this song is, you know, when he talks about, do you wear a black armband when they shot the man who said peace could last forever? And in my first memories they shot Kennedy, I went numb when I learned to see. So I never fell for Vietnam, got the wall of the sea to remind us all that you can't trust freedom when it's not in your hands, when everybody's fighting for the promised land. That verse, when I first heard that all the way back in 91 when they released the albums, that sort of woke me up to how the world works. Some say that my thinking is my thinking is sort of like shouldn't be how we think today. We should be told what to do, and if you don't like it, you get all the shit thrown at you. I say fuck that. Can anyone be free when your freedoms are taken away from you? By governments, politicians, the old bill. I say fuck it. Do you know why? Because I'm a free thinker. I don't need people telling me what I can and can't think. If I think you're being out of order, I'll tell you. So look, being out of order, I appreciate you, that's your position and whatever, but, you know, and you're more than welcome to have that opinion. But don't tell me what to think. I can think for myself. You know, it's that simple. Think for yourself. Don't get told what you can and can't fucking do. And it's lines like that sort of wake you up to what's going on in the world, you know. I mean, take the elections, okay? Now, this is not an endorsement for any of them, right? It's only from an outsider's perspective of what's happening in America. You know, there's something about Biden that troubles me. I'm sorry, but there is. He's very creepy. He, be quite honest, I've seen some of his speeches, and he's not all there. Sorry, but there's something wrong with him. You know, if he gets in, then it'll only be a few weeks before he's booted out, but not being well, and that whatever her name is, Kamala Harris or something like that, she'll become the president. Now, I've heard some of her sort of rhetoric on, speeches and things, and to me, she's no better. Trump, well, we all know Trump, he's a loose cannon. I get that. The only thing I can say about Trump is, that he does what he says he's going to do. And in my lifetime, all politicians have said is, we'll do this for you, we'll do that for you. And they don't. Whereas Trump, I can't believe I'm saying this, but, Trump says he's going to do this and he's going to do this, and he does it. I don't agree with everything Trump says. I don't. I think he's a bit of a loose cannon. But one thing I will say about him is that he does do what he says he's going to do. Whereas with Biden and Harris, I just get a feeling that your freedoms won't be in your hands. And that's all I can say about it. And that's from an outsider's sort of view. And I'm not saying, either one of them is, better than the other, because I don't think that at all. I don't. But there's something about Biden Harris that I don't know what else to say, but that's my thoughts on it anyway. I'm not endorsing any of them. Couldn't be bothered about it. Not my country, but if you live in America, it is your country. I'm just sort of saying this from an outsider's perspective. But you got to do what you got to do, But yeah, it's lines like that in that song that just sort of wake you up. That's why I like it. I don't know. Whatever you think is, the way to go, and it's up to you. But I just get a funny feeling that you're going to be thrown into a few new wars. And I just get a funny feeling that many more human lives will be lost. Yeah, that's all I can say on that, I'm sorry. But yeah, that was Guns N' Roses Civil War in Paris 1992. And that was for MMB TV. I hope you enjoyed it. Sorry if I had a bit of a little sort of rant there. It wasn't a rant, it was just being as an ordinary person. His take on it, because it's just dominating the news all over the fucking world, and over the last 4 years, even though I don't agree with some of the things Trump has said or whatever, you got to give it to the man that he says what he's going to do and he does it. Who would you rather trust, the devil you know or the devil you don't? It's that simple. Anyway, I shall leave it there. Because, like I said, I'm not endorsing any of them, and I wouldn't want to. We've got enough shit over here in this country, so... Anyway. Please leave a like, please subscribe, please check out my other videos. And I shall catch you all in the next one. Peace. Thank you.